I'm going to start this off by, I'm very nervous right now, so I don't know how well this is going to go, but we're going to try my best. So I'm going to start this off with a story about me. And it's going to sound like I'm reliving my glory days of my football career, but I promise you, it has a point to it. So it starts off in third grade. In third grade, I decided to play football for my first time. I was the only girl on the team, and it was kind of weird, but I had fun. Then I decided to take a break and try other sports. See what, I probably played anything if you named it. I played soccer, basketball, softball, anything. But nothing made me more happier than football. So I went back to it in seventh grade. And we had a good year. It was great. We only lost 2 games. And it was to Hartford, Vermont, and to Guilford. But Hartford, Vermont wasn't even in our, like, league. It was just a fun game that Bow Youth Football decided to put on. And we even went to the championship that year. And we won. We won against Guilford. It was a good year, except that was the first year my shoulder decided to dislocate. And I went to the doctors. They told me, yeah, just go out for a week. It'll be fine. Then I went back to football after that week. I decided to tackle back. It came out again. Then I went to a chiropractor thinking maybe my shoulder needed to be realigned or something like that. Like maybe the chiropractor could help because the doctor obviously didn't know what they were talking about. And then he said be out for another week. And I listened. I was out for 2 weeks and that was that. And then I went back and my shoulder came out again. But this time, I didn't want to sit out. So I didn't tell my teammates, I didn't tell my coaches, and I didn't tell my parents. I played through the pain. And we won the championship, so that was what mattered, right? At least that's what my mindset was. And then in eighth grade, I decided to play again, because it was still made me the happiest, even though I was playing through some pain. I mean, we went an undefeated season. We even made it back to the championship again and won again, back-to-back years in a row. We even beat at Hartford, Vermont, the first time in 10 years for Bulldog history. We were a history-making team. That was what we were. That was what I wanted to be a part of still. I didn't want to sit out. And so after eighth grade, I came to ninth grade. And I knew it had to be amped up a little bit. You're going to be playing against bigger kids, stronger kids, and frankly, a whole lot faster kids too. And for the first time in my life, I got scared to play football. So I told my coaches my shoulder was finally bothering me. And he told me I should go to the doctors. So I went to the doctor at Concord Orthopedics, and he said you should go to Boston Children's Hospital. And there I got diagnosed with EDS. Does anyone know what that is? Raise your hands if you do. I would be shocked if actually if you guys knew what that is. It's called Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. It basically means your ligaments stretch out and they don't return. So nothing really holds right in my shoulders. That's why my shoulders dislocate so easily. So they told me I couldn't play any more contact sports ever again. That's what they told me. They told me there is absolutely no way to fix it. So I lost my sport that I loved. And barely any sport that I ever wanted to do. So I started getting depressed really easily. And I figured, what can I do? What can I get back? I lost my sport. I don't know what to do anymore. And then this senior project came up. And I was like, what can I do to get football back involving this senior project? So I decided to coach. Mostly because of what the Bow Youth Football program stood for. It stood for pride, persistence, respect, integrity, dedication, and effort. They didn't just apply that on the football field. They applied that in school, in your community, in your home life. Coaches would even check up on you at school to make sure you're doing the right thing. Make sure you're on honor roll. If you weren't, you were expected to stay home from a practice to do homework. That was what was expected of you. And that's what I wanted to be a part of. So I decided to coach the third, fourth, and fifth grade team. And they were pretty adorable. There's a lot of stories I could tell you, but I'm not going to get into all that. They were hilarious. I have some photos of Colin and Garrison, thanks to my team moms. Actually, I did not get all these photos. I'm not that good at taking photos. Colin, if any of you guys know Tanner Kamet, I think Colin's actually his cousin. So that's kind of like my relating it to Bow High School. And I chose this photo of Garrison because he never gave up on that play. He was behind the guy, but he dove at his feet and made an awesome shoestring tackle. And it was great. He was the happiest I've ever seen him after making that hit. So, and then I do have a video to show you guys. Liked the video. Thanks to our actually team moms, someone made that. It was originally 22 minutes long because it had all the teams from BYF in it, not just the third, fourth, and fifth grade. Believe it or not, even after that great video, we only won one game. And that was extremely hard on me. This is where my story kind of comes into play. I grew up winning championships. going to the championship. In high school, when I got to high school, I still wasn't playing, but our football team made it to the championship. Sophomore year, we made it to the championship. Junior year, we made it to the semifinals. Senior year, we made it to the semifinals again. For me, that was extremely hard to make. After losing 4 weeks in a row, I started getting down on myself, thinking, what am I doing wrong? I'm trying to teach these kids how to play, and they're working their butts off every day and doing what they're asked of, but it's not producing any wins. And that's when it hit me that I was missing the wrong point. Winning isn't everything, because they were having fun just playing the sport that they loved with all their friends. That's what mattered. And I was missing that. And that was something that was the biggest realization for me. So this was our last helmets up. At the end of every practice, every game, we do a helmets up. Basically, we pick a player who demonstrates the pride standard and who demonstrates leadership in that game or practice, who basically goes above and beyond. And that was my last helmets up as a coach, so it was extremely important to me. So I got to pick. That was what they let me do. And I picked everyone. It happened to be our last game was the only game we won. So they were all extremely happy. But it was hard for me because I knew I was leaving these kids. I spent days with them, hours with them. And now I'm going to college. And I'm not going to be here to coach them anymore. That was really hard on me. But what I did for the research part of my project was something that was extremely important to me as well. Because I struggle from mental illness. I struggle from depression, anxiety, and borderline personality disorder. I'm not afraid to tell you guys that. So what my essential question was what effects do physical activity and sports have in mental illness on students? So how I implemented that in my project was if any kids seemed off that day or at practice, I went up to them and said, hey, what's going on? Like, you need to talk. And most of the times they did. Most of the time they told me about how school was going. And it made them happy. It made them a little bit better. I remember one kid, his dad was a coach. So his dad was a little bit harder on him. And he went to the sideline crying because his dad yelled at him because he missed a tackle. And I went over to him and I was like, hey, I can relate to you. My dad was my coach in third grade too. He was hard on me too. You're new to this sport. You're gonna miss tackles. Just go out and try your hardest. That's all that matters. And he stopped crying and smiled, and went back out there and had the best game he's ever had. So that was what was important to me. I mean, everyone knows the benefits. Everyone knows the benefits of sports, like improving social skills, improving motor and cognitive skills, making new friends, time management skills. Everyone knows those. Those are the pretty big ones that anyone can find out. Everyone knows the benefits of exercise. I mean, obviously the big one is controlling your weight. Controlling your insulin levels, your blood pressure, your risk of heart disease. But most people don't know the one big one that I'm trying to point out. Is exercise can improve your mental health and mood as well. And I think most people think they have to do something big. They don't. Even something really simple can diminish depression and anxiety by 26%. And all it has to be, it doesn't have to be, I'm not saying you have to go out and walk 3 miles. I'm not saying you have to go run a marathon. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying something as simple as going for a 10-minute walk can change your mood. That's all it takes. And so that would be my two takeaways. Winning isn't everything, and 15 minutes or 10 minutes can change your day. Thank you.